Over 51 million people are currently fleeing armed conflict, more than at any time since the Second World War. And almost half of them are children.
They come shooting, they were killing everyone. Whether you are a man, woman, a young, whatever, you are blind, deaf, they put them inside the house, then they just burn the house.
But what's it like as a child to lose everything that is familiar and safe and find yourself trying to build a new life in a refugee camp?
I don't even today where are we going to sleep. There's no home, no house.
Can you still be a child when war is forcing you to grow up? And what do the children think is most important when their world has been turned upside down?
I just want to go back to school and complete my studies. I want to be in those lives before.
Four children show us what life is like when you are forced to flee your home.
The life of refugees is not that good. There's no future development. Only you eat, you sleep. That is the end.
It's rainy season in South Sudan, and for a few months, the weather has silenced the guns in Africa's longest-running civil war. 14-year-old Anna is among the 1.5 million people who have been forced to flee because of the fighting. For her, the rain is a reminder of happier, more peaceful times.
When it is raining, I miss my house. I cannot go anywhere, I can stay inside the house. It's not good. Some water are falling down now.
Anna came to Minkeman camp 8 months ago, along with the rest of her family.
They are asking me that, why don't you change the food? I tell them that there is no another food. So that is the problem. They don't want to eat this youngest kid. Because we have eaten 3 days.
We eat this rice in 3 days. And today, 4. 4 days.
And why can't you change the food?
There is no another type of food. We have no money. So this was being brought by WFP.
The war in South Sudan has claimed over 2 million lives. When the fighting reached Anna and Grace's town, they had to cross the River Nile at the dead of night to escape.
7 days. You
see, someone is being killed ahead of you, and someone is being killed behind of you, and you are still running.
Then I get fear.
Water was near us, so people just ran into water. So most of the children who don't know to swim, they just draw. Because the river that we crossed was very long. It can take distance of 30 minutes while you are swimming, and if you don't know swimming, you cannot be able to cross. What you were thinking about is, are you going to live? Are you going to be alive, or you are going to be dead?
Anna's father is a Christian preacher and still believes peace will reign one day.
yene ka chok da bung no masayo di ke ji amere ada e ke chol dor dor angi ku a chini kra a chini tong ko chini kra e ko no tin a ko or bu dor bu ya ti je nong nyali yene ka bi dor pindo junub
ki a ni arba loganita ai wi je ga ya galo lo chan banam pirate yen ga ya loganita Because Rio Jadi, Rio Jakinja, Niger Rio Jaja, Angela Board.
Kilometers to the south of Anna and Grace's camp. Uganda is currently home to over 160,000 refugees from South Sudan. Over 200 new refugees are arriving at this camp every day. After health checks and inoculations, new arrivals are given official refugee status, entitling them to aid. In time, they will be moved on to settlement camps where they'll be given a plot of land. But with so many fleeing the war, this can take weeks. One of the new arrivals is 14-year-old Scovia.
Since we came here, our life is not the way we used to be. Life is different here.
Scovia's family had a thriving retail business in South Sudan, but lost everything in the war when their shops were looted. Scovia spends most of her time helping her mother look after the younger children and dealing with the bureaucracy of the refugee camp.
The cards, they give it. When you're going to for reception to receive the food, then you go with the cart. Then they give you food.
You're not in the line.
Nutrition in the camp supposedly gives all the necessary calories and vitamins for a healthy diet. But Scovia is not impressed. She misses the variety of food she used to enjoy at home.
Food is not the way we need. At home, when you eat, there are balanced diets. We eat fruits, meat also, we eat greens. Chicken. We refugees. At home, when you wanted to go to take shower, you open water from up. Here, it is completely different. We don't have those here. Baraka, nji bomo mu yijere. Nkade yala maje. Ani ko, baraka awo, mani je. Awo ko baraka. What kid are you looking for, Marcus? Ita biligo wa saka ni na teli na bidoro fe ugaba na gora fe ugaba. Ode kama kid are Marcus. Makana mafisi na nasba kara kara sambala zaman kana yanda kolera zee kolera kira gobo na nasketi.
Scovia's experience isn't unusual. UNHCR estimates that around a third of refugee camps don't have decent toilets.
life can be school difficulties for a year. For sake like that, then my life will quest. Then I will feel okay.
Look at the man in the water. He's in a lot of trouble.
In our house, there was air condition. When it was hot, you just go and put it on.
You relax there.
Na kuli na gili mu na gani television. Lakini ni mafi television mafi. Nuruza to mafi. Sala kanzola dara garasu ye kida yani story relation mafi.
Aba isa tapi seru.
The refugees.
Jumi kita tamal lari. Kau bina kita apa dijarin?
Ada kenyana kau man mikoman ma. Man mata syukur ga.
Since we are the future, the world is full
of trouble. I'm not feeling okay the way I used to be. I just want to go back to school and complete my studies. I want to be in those lives before, the good lives, not like this one. Near here, I'm completely not good. I'm not fine here.
Back in South Sudan, Anna and Grace share Scovia's dream of returning to full-time education. There's a school in the local town that was built for 300 pupils, but with the children from the camp now attending as well, numbers have swelled to over 1,000. Everything is in short supply, even chairs.
People are complaining that the stomach is paining because of the beans. What, the grain is not okay?
But with the school so overcrowded, some parents are not bothering to send their children. A decision of which Anna strongly disapproves.
Education is very important because of the following reason. If you are an educated person, nothing will be difficult. I can be a minister, doctor, teacher or what, if I am educated.
Anna feels so passionately about the value of education that she's joined a student group campaigning to get all the camp's children into school. Around 28 million children worldwide can't attend school because of armed conflict. Here in South Sudan, at least 500,000 children are affected.
What I like to do this, I want somebody to be like me, as I am talking with you now. If a person who is illiterate person cannot talk with you, but now I have learned in the school, that is why I am talking with you now.
Unfortunately for Anna's sister, Grace, the school is only for primary grade children. There's no high school within walking distance of the camp.
I'm a student, but there's no high school here. This means the education is not okay. The life here in the camp, all you eat, you sleep. That is the end.
Grace's ambition is to work in medicine. So while her education is on hold, she's working in a camp clinic.
We do awareness, mobilization, and we give first aid to the people who are having different sickness. We get a lot of malaria positive plus diarrhea. Water with diarrhea, so many people are having water with diarrhea here. And it's because of the contamination that it is here.
Diarrhea and malaria are two of the leading killers of children in Africa, and kids in camps are especially at risk.
When the crisis happened, so many people were just running. People were thinking of their death. When people run, there is always weakness of the body, which is general body weakness. So, and this one is broad when there is crisis. So when I see this, I feel annoyed. The child has been brought back and is RDT positive.
The RDT positive is malaria.
Yeah.
So now, this is for malaria.
I myself, I was having malaria. I was malaria positive, but my sister was malaria positive. So I want to be a chemist because this issue of some disease is killing people here. I don't like. So I really want to be a chemist.
While Grace tries to help the camp's children in the clinic, her younger sister Anna has taken her campaign for universal education to the airwaves. She's broadcasting on the camp's radio station to encourage parents to send their kids to school.
We, the youth, we are the future of the country. The old age, like my father, they will not be there after 40 years, and we shall be the one who will take over. If I'm educated, then I can do something very nice for the country. These I say that said, to educate a girl is to educate a nation. So the more I will be educated, the more I will bring our home up and our family, and likewise to the community.
Back in the refugee camp in Uganda, Scovia and her family are finally being moved on to a settlement camp in a place called Ilo, where they hope to be able to start a new life. Over 1,000 people are being relocated. It's a massive operation that will take several days.
Today we are going to Ilo for the settlement. There are many people, so many. I don't know if the cars are going to be enough for us. Because the squeezing is going to be there.
Another young refugee on the move is 14-year-old John. Like many of the children here, he's struggling to come to terms with the horrors he witnessed back home in South Sudan. John lost his father in the fighting and arrived in the camp with his mother and sisters just 2 weeks ago.
وكان وقاعد في الجيش ياهو وكان فار الحرب قلنا له وراه ما قبل ياهو كان يلا مشى فضل هناك ياهو مات ضربه في الحرب فكروا مشى شديد حرب ده مشى كتير وناس كتير ماتوا مشى سنة كتير لما جيني مازي got this boy in يلا لما جيت دقوا اسامي بتاني هناك فوق انا بقعد مرتاح عشان نمشي وزولينا بيننا نمشي نقعد مرتاح في البيت بملوا اول اوضه مداور يلا بخذ حاجات في راسه وقنايات في راسه كده يلا يا هو يلا بدقش في راسه يلا يلا بطو بجنني زيره قاعد طويل زيره كده يا بقى زيره
Dio Manyok.
Is there?
Nyariag is there.
Is there?
Sara.
Is there?
That happened,
Mori Jesse.
Mori Jesse, now we have
Jacqueline Naito Joseph.
Please come, time is not on our side.
Emi, Emike. You want to go to
Pana? I'm going to go to Pana.
Cecilia, Pua.
Di thawan ni ola sare le jan ni ola ire le
Are you happy to come here on the city?
I like the city of Barake.
I don't even today where are we going to sleep? There's no home, no house, no market even. It's very tough. A tough place.
The families are given basic items for survival, like machetes, cooking pots, and plastic sheets, before being allocated their plots.
Ah, no, don't lie now. They are calling your name exactly.
Ah, here, 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 here,
here,
here, here,
These are cooking utensils, mosquito net, and basin, cup, soap. Okay, there's also panga. Slash also is there in Denho.
Each family is also given a month's worth of food, and John and his mum Mary are waiting to collect their share. But the local Ugandan camp commander has to work through an interpreter, so misunderstandings are inevitable.
This one, you'll keep it, you'll go for food. Everybody will take one bag. Then the one remaining, you get a container, you scoop equally. You people, can you understand what I'm saying for you? I'm saying you are 13. They have given you 15 bags. This balance here is supposed to be two. Where's the other one? It's only one. Where's the other one? No, still there is a problem here. They have given 15 bags. Are you getting me? They are 13. Each gets a seat. They're supposed to have two bags remaining. It's one. Who is this?
Red.
Mama, for Peter, where is the bag sitting now?
Now
you divide this among yourselves. That's what I wanted. We are going to call, I'm going to call these things names according to the arrangement. And we are going to give plot 30 by 20. We are starting.
Nagibada.
You are following me?
Yeah. Wrong thing, Dakon.
18, 19, 20. Mary, make a sign here. Direct on the roadside, eh?
Yeah. Yes.
Make a sign here. Your border. You type for him. Hey. Direct on the roadside.
This one. Okay. Mary.
Mary.
Major.
Yes.
Come. Wait, eh?
Okay.
Hello. We are going to wait, eh?
One. I'm going to get married. 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 I'm
going to
ما في يوم انا عملت هاي اول يوم انا فكر عشان ابوي ما في وانا شغال كده عشان قاعد نشتغل براي بقيت تعبان انا
بقيت تعبان ما تتكسر يدها
تحجر لبرا
ما تقدر
انا بقدر له
يوه ما بطلع. ما بطلع.
أنا بطلع يا.
ما بطلع ها؟
أنا بطلع.
كان يعجب ما أبغى أوكي كم بالله وده كده لا بي. أروح أقول. بدينا سهني شديد يا خان. خلو حبة لبكرة. أنا يجي سوي يجي نضيفها.
بكرة أنا عشان ما نجي ثاني.
Scovia is also waiting for her family plot.
We are giving plot 20 by 30 per family. So I'm going to make it this way 30,
yeah.
This way 20. That's per family, eh?
Right.
I don't know that there was a place called even Ilo. I don't know even there was a place called Ilo. I just came to know it that we are in refugees camp. That's when I came to know that. It is only starting new life here. We are going to learn through it. Yeah. I think we will have now new life, good life. Starting new life is hard to start, but when it has taken some months, yeah, you will feel okay, you know that you are somewhere now. You started somewhere, new life.
Shoot him!
Hey!
Grace has left the camp in South Sudan and travelled for 7 days, almost 200 miles into neighbouring Kenya.
Shoot him! Shoot him, Eric! Shoot him!
We use them as guns because people, our parents have been fighting for so long. So we just resemble what they use. Say this is our gun, so someone shot someone using water.
Grace's younger sister Anna and the rest of the family have stayed in the camp in South Sudan. But Grace is determined to find a safe secondary school willing to give her a place, so she can start to catch up on the months of education she's missed.
I was talking to my dad always that, my dad, I have to go for a school. I have to go for his studies. He was telling me that, where are you going to get a school? I was telling him that I have to go to Kenya.
The journey south to Kenya was long and dangerous. Once again, Grace had to run for her life when fighting broke out in a camp where she was staying for the night.
We just ran again. They just come again, killing people. And they kill another woman near to me. And I was sleeping, so I was being told to wake up. I was just asking myself, why do I bother myself to come and look for a school? Why can't I stay like some of the students who are staying in Bo and some of the students who are staying in Minkaman without a school? Why do I bother myself to come here? I ran with the books. Even I did not run with any clothes, but I just ran with the books. I will be doing sciences. So, and I want to be a doctor. And if I don't read biology well, I will not pass. So that is why I was holding this book. This book now is very old, but I have to take care of it. This is where it has get broken. But I have put a small rope here to control it. But here there are no rope. You see, it is like this.
Dozens of families from South Sudan live in this part of Kenya. There are around 500 refugee children living with distant relatives or family friends. These families are undocumented, and because they're not officially refugees, they don't qualify for any aid. Grace is staying with an auntie who looks after 20 refugee children. Just feeding that many little mouths is a constant struggle.
Now all these children, they need food. We all need food. So anytime though, like what happened yesterday, we did not get food. Likewise to today, we did not get food. Even later in the evening, I don't know what will happen.
Grace's auntie also fled from the violence. She was heavily pregnant at the time.
Kecil kan? Kau tidak rokok? ñoonu ca bac téna toy ci umet ke ci lungti na jëmme jaame diet ko adam ga na to ko taam to ku tiim ba may loy di bac war way ci ga ya ba ga dang ci ga na na ci ra jo loyan ci anam ja kiet ja ting ba may ci war way bac war wi ba waan ku karatuk ku ka jaamu ke ga dang ja ra ta ya te na pe wala yena man ku ci war wi kana man ya kan ya lay ci akoy na waane ne tan kan ya lay ci akoy yena mon ba mo u ba to ye waga man num ba ba yakon jaan me do ja ci nga andar wa apto bu ko ban jufa bu ko jaam ya ka wala jamme ja lay mo sey fa ko jamil ke joko yo jokalie joka ni ban bi ka juba ko bi ke kurale tien to taw ka tin dadu ka ken en ka ya yen dine pio
Grace has applied to a top local boarding school. Today, she finds out if she's got in.
Hi, madam.
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine.
You came the other time
yes.
to ask for a place.
Yes.
And we are pleased that we gave you a place after finishing to do the interview.
That is great, mommy.
You're welcome.
Passing the entrance exam was the first hurdle. Now Grace has to work out how to pay the fees.
By the end of the year, I'm going to pay around 39,400 Kenya shilling, which is around 450 UK pound. Which is really very much for me to find. It is really very difficult for me to find. It's a lot of money. I don't know what will be the solution afterward. I have to be in boarding so that I will be just focusing on schooling. So the poem, I have already get the poem and I see all these things. So the planning now is to go back to Sudan and talk to the dad. What will the dad say about this poem that I have found?
Back in Uganda, Scovia and her family are determined to make a new life on the plot they've been given. They're gradually clearing the land to build more permanent shelters.
Look at my hands, I'm slashing, cleaning and compost.
And how long have you been doing it?
Since morning. Slashing, since morning, it is too hard. Even now my hands are, I'm tired of it.
Mo esa sangulu mo min donki dag asante bitu gut nin jirki za to mushkila ta mabu gerdu no kan ten na fibet na gifata mo min fa mo fi fibet yani hamam za to mafin da zor kera ber fi gaba
gun for you
ma boy
this is a gun
yes
yes
Die, don't die. To die.
You go stand.
God, barao. Kaya alo na mawali fure. Zay alo na yeye ni rasere. Numfi gabare. Bara. La na mawali fure wago. Wata na majeru fure yomko. Mana ma fikira san kan gua tinna kan kwes ko sulu kwes adi oh tapi geni be sambala ta ma ji fikira ya oh ma fi za ta fi mukta gali fa ya zere gi ja hasil ya ja hasil kaman it's not totally the place I wish to be
yeah
cuz this place is not very good to stay in it's not enjoyable anymore. The children of South Sudan have suffered too much through this fighting.
It's aid distribution day, and John has come to collect his month's rations. Two and a half million people in the region are currently facing severe food shortages. With so many in need and barely enough supplies, tensions run high. Without the skills or strength to clear the forest and build a shelter, John and his mother abandoned their plot. They've gone to a more established refugee camp to join John's aunt and her family. 27,000 refugees already live here.
Ma vizol ba mnilena fogo. Uma fugurusha chenne dulena sijeje mnulena.
John has other worries on his mind as well. His mum is on a dangerous return trip to South Sudan to tie up her late husband's affairs. John is scared she won't come back.
Nga ni fukuru khala sen uma fi gaje mbena ma murta. Kena sana dia raja, kan makan nelga berseri. Sukar syai, syai itu sabah makan nelga fogo. Bu sukar, bu leben. Gana fakir sabu ibu sama gana fakir visor. Anak-anak lo gana kau mabu yang gana kun murtah. Habis syal lah syal lo gaya jambi saya kena gana kun murtah.
going to help you.
Grace has returned safely to Kenya. Her father gave her enough money to put a deposit on a place in the boarding school and buy basics like books, a uniform, and a mattress.
How are you?
Zuri.
Hey, how are you?
I'm fine.
How much is this small mattress right here?
750.
750. What of the last price?
Last price for you, I make it 700.
My lord. But I was having 650, so...
No. The last price for you, I'll make it 700.
700, yeah.
She's still hoping to get to university one day, but knows it will be a long haul.
After 9 years. Yes, maybe I will be a refugee for 9 years. While struggling for education, then after education, officer somewhere. I see that the future will be bright, and it must be bright. I will have a bright future.
Grace has been out of education for over a year. She's keen to get to boarding school to focus on her studies and escape the childcare duties that are part of living with her aunt.
Grace! Bye, back to school, guys. Bye.
So I will be going to school. And that's very nice. It is really very good. Long time without seeing school. It is a very nice day.
Sadly, after all she's been through, Grace is about to be dealt another blow. The school has decided to put her back a year to Form 1. And not only that, a teacher strike means the first year won't be starting for at least another month.
We want you to have a good foundation.
Yes.
That is why we said you should go back to Form 1. Okay. So now the Form 1s are opening in February, around 4th.
On the 4th.
Yes, we are really not sure because the strike is on.
Yeah.
Please don't get disappointed. Feb is just on the way, it's not far. But even as you go home and wait for February, I would encourage you, number one, to take care of yourself.
It is really too far because what I programmed when I was coming from Sudan, I was making Christmas on the way. Why? Mm-hmm. Because I've planned it that it is smart for me on the 6th to report myself to the school. So that was the plan, but now the planning is all disorganized. I wait until February.
Yes, you wait until February, then you come in. Look here, it's January, and we are soon going to February.
I'm not feeling good. Why did they make it like that? I'm really so disappointed. Why I program and I plan, and before when I come, they agree exactly. I asked them exactly. I came exactly on day 6. They were telling me that you must come on day 6. And even they write in my admission form, if you come late, then you will be out of the school. And now they are putting it up to paper.
Do you ever feel like just saying enough is enough, I'm going home?
Ah, no, that is not in my planning. It's at all not in my planning, that one. I don't want that. So I want to have education. That's my shipment and that's my planning. So I must have education, unless I'm dead. But if I'm alive, I must achieve.
Just 5 weeks after being led into grass taller than she was, Scovia and her family have finished clearing their compound. They've put up temporary shelters for now, but are making mud bricks to build more permanent homes.
This is our new compound. These are the bricks. Our house is going to be met with. Our mother's room is built temporary, and that's the house where she is sleeping, inside.
Sure.
Then that is my grandmother's plot, and that is the house also she is sleeping in. That is her room. But we are together there sleeping with them. This is my aunt's compound, sister to my father. That is where she parked her car. It is like garage. When she came back, that is where she parked her car. This is my auntie. This is where she is cooking. This is her kitchen. And that one is the place where she kept utensils there. This is our shop. Today here is my sister, Jacqueline. Of course, we make duties.
To make money for building materials and school fees, Scovia's family is hard at work. Over 12,000 refugees have been placed here so far, and more are coming. With so many people taking water to make bricks as well as for everyday use, the boreholes in the area are starting to run dry.
Water is a problem because this is the only borehole around here. The line is very long. That's why it is taking so long to fill one jerrycan. It's a problem even. You get early in the morning, you take your buckets, your jerrycans, you put them in line. When you didn't wake early, you will not find water.
Around half the refugee camps in the world have problems with water shortages. But for the younger children, there are higher priorities.
We are making a football field.
My hope is to achieve a better life later. I'm dreaming to become an accountant. If I stay here, I don't think so. My future is going to be bright the way I need. Because there's no any good school here, I see. If there's no school here somewhere also in town, maybe there are schools. I will go.
With so many children desperate for an education, schools are starting to be built. The refugee camps are taking on an air of permanence, with brick buildings replacing tents and new wash blocks going up. As the flood of refugees continues, the camps are becoming small towns in their own right. And there's good news for John. His mum has made it safely back to Uganda. The family is together once again.
Kalam daka man kan
yaw zaman gafalo shara da galo shara ba fulan ba git khayib shadid an guta shara mikin gafalo ana hena wi yale hena bu kun saf
wait wait wait
wait
wow
wait
again
the
way wait wait
wait heli aldena so godu quiz taro na kisam lo jana tetel lo jana shafu kitaga tamal haja kab jana bugul haja desem mumkin hubamlo lo tamal haja quiz jana yaw bishuf mumkin bugul ay haja de namlo zola gari amlo
In Kenya, Grace's dream of returning to education has finally come true. Frustrated with the delays at the first school and struggling to pay fees in advance, Grace found another school, slightly further away, that would accept just a deposit while her father tries to raise the rest of the year's fees.
I'm happy. The school is very nice. The school's smart. My dream, I want to become a doctor. Being a doctor is a very important work. Because you are assisting those who are sick, you are near to God. At least God is ahead of you, then you are the second person. The more you commit yourself, the more you gain the goal. I'm in high school, so I think my future will be bright. You cannot be suffering for so long.
I love him and be a minister. Kunaja a minister and meet quite even with Abaka. Be me, be so cool, be alone. I just cool, look, I think to be me by a pen, so cool, even with others.
Nelim Tan Lonagber, and a family baby Ali, Nagber Nam, and Ayat Katir. Lose Rabidai.
Jana dar ke odilo righto akil ke kon fi basic needs madrasa zemoyo ke kon fi akil fi obligo fritan kono bala
Attempts to organize a group game turned instead into something more aggressive. Hunt the hedgehog.
Oh, did you see that move?
Did you see that move?
Inside, it kind of went. Did you see that move?
Yeah, I saw that move.
Scared. Look, watch it move, watch it.
We're gonna kill some hedgehogs.
Can't hear you, that stupid.
Boom it up.
At this point, the film crew decided to intervene.